So Jessica, what is the first thing you ask a man when you first meet him? What do he do for a living? Exactly. I knew that's what the first thing you ask, because 90-something% of women, that's the first thing they ask men is what he do for a living. You know why? Why? No. No. Because that's the only question that really matters to you. People usually ask what matters to them first. You concerned about what he do for a living because that's gonna base how you're gonna treat him, how you're gonna laugh at his jokes, how available you're gonna make yourself to him, is going to be based on what he say he do for a living. So that's what that is. But you're gonna understand is he could be a serial killer. You know what I mean? He probably can't have kids. He could be anything. He could be a rapist. He could be a devil worshiper, but you're not concerned about all that. You know, in your mind, a broke man could be a rapist, a serial killer too, but you're not giving a fair chance to all men. You're only giving a fair chance to guys that have a certain financial criteria that can drop today or tomorrow. Just because somebody have today, it don't mean they're gonna have next month, next year. You have all kind of emergencies come up, all kind of illnesses, car accidents. You have bad investments. You know, people get sued. You have stuff that take place in the bank. You don't know what's going to happen to somebody's finances. So just to base somebody, who you're going to live with, who you're going to give your body to, is based on how much they make and what they do for a living. That's indirect prostitution, Jessica. Am I right or wrong? Exactly. Don't indirectly prostitute yourself. A lot of these guys nowadays know that women are indirectly prostituting themselves. That's why they act in the way they do. That's why they're doing what they do. Because they know that these women would not deal with them if they didn't have certain stuff. Have you always been that way? You say you got it from your friends? Yeah. You picked that stuff up. You might have been a good woman. You might have been, not saying you evil now, but you may have been a more simple or pure woman. But the fact that you hanging around girls that keep talking about what the man do for a living, you consciously want to impress your friends. You want to bring a man around and say, he this, he that, oh, he got this and that. You don't say nothing about then only thing that matters about his personality is after you name the stuff superficial. So the real stuff about him don't matter unless he got the superficial stuff. And I think that's crazy, and that's why the relationships, that's the one of the relationship problem, the biggest relationship problem coming from women. That's the biggest problem from women. The biggest problem from men is we think we can nice our way into a woman that has the body. The woman that has the body and the mind. I mean, the body and the looks that we want. You see what I'm saying? We think we can, if we do this and that, or we think we can change. You can't change people. Now, if somebody really say they see themselves need a change, and you point it out, and they see what you're saying, and they want to make a change on their own because they see what you're saying, they got sense enough to know when somebody else is making more sense to them, then they're making a change on their own because they got sense enough to be able to admit that they have an error that need to be corrected. So, you know, women have to stop that. Women have to stop basing it because the divorce rate is high. It's not working. That way is not working. You see what I'm saying? What's the longest you've been in a relationship, Jessica? 3 months? That's not a relationship, Jessica. That's almost not even a fling. You've been skipping from one guy to the next because you're basing a man's worth on money, looks, and status. And that's why you keep skipping from one ham bone to the next. It's gonna wear your vag out. It's gonna wear your wap out. You know what I'm saying? By the time you meet somebody half decent, your WAP gonna look like soaked lettuce. And you don't want that. That good man don't deserve that. So I'm here to let you know right now, don't do that. Don't ask a man what he do for a living. Ask him what's on his heart, what's on his mind. Because guess what? If you really love him, you really care about him, you're going to want to grow with him. If you want him to have money, you help him have money. You want him to wear a suit, you help him pick out a suit, buy a suit. That's what you do. Don't miss out on a good man. A godly man, a good man. Just because a suit, just because a job. Because without the person, none of that ain't gonna matter. Okay, you got a man that got a career that smacked the spit out your mouth. He got a good job, a false sense of security. Okay, he make $200,000 a year. $300,000 a year. But he smacked the spit out your mouth in that nice, beautiful house with security and money in the bank. You can brag to your female, your friends about, oh, I got a night. He bought me a new car. Did you tell him how he smacked the spit out your mouth the other night? You don't want that, Jessica. Life is very strange. You have to grab people that really have you in your best interest. Hopefully you have people and men in your best interest. Because people can sense when you don't have them in their best interest. And sometimes two fake people meet each other and they expect to get something real out of a fake situation. I just get with a girl because of her body. I don't really care about her mind, her personality. I know I don't really like it, but I'm still dealing with her. I'm forcing myself to be with her even though I know I don't like the way she talk. I don't like the way she think. I don't like her heart. I don't like her mind. You know, she don't like my mind. She don't like my heart. We don't have nothing, you know, we don't have nothing in common or nothing. But she got a nice body. I got money. I got the career that she want. So we a match made in hell. We match made in hell. Don't be a match made in hell, Jessica. Get in a real situation where you can grow so you can grow together. Every couple should have their own business anyway. The problem with a lot of my clients, they call me, the male clients tell me, I don't know if my wife really loved me. I cheat on her because I don't know if she really loved me. That's what my male clients tell me all the time. I don't even know if my wife really loved me anyway. She met me while I was making $200,000, $300,000 a year when she met me. I don't know if she loved me. Everybody smile at me now. They can look at my watch and tell me I got money. They can look at my car and tell me I got something going on. So they just smiley faces. So that's why you got to get to know a man, mind, heart, and personality. Don't focus just on his, what he do for a living. Oh, I'm going to act real nice. I'm going to make myself real available for him now that he got a so-called credible job title, credible career. But God don't like that. And, you know, it's an unnecessary lesson to learn. You know, it's hard to grow with a person. It's hard to accept the person while they down or while they, you know, it's not happening yet. It's hard. But look at you. Your way haven't been working. You're 36 years old. Still single, no kids. You got a nice body. You got money yourself. You still want a man to make more than you and you make $100,000 a year. You want a man to make more than you and you make $100,000 a year. It's just never enough. Everything is based on measurements, and you put love as the last thing of your equation. Anyway, Jessica, we're going to make a follow-up tomorrow. Text me a good time for you, and I'll make myself available. I got other clients, but I'll make myself available for you because you paid in advance. Anyway, just to, you know, I'll talk to you tomorrow, and think about what I said. Have a great day. Guys, watch out for women to ask you what you do for a living. Ladies, Don't choose a man just because of his career. Choose him because you love him. You like his personality, his mind, his thoughts, his actions, and his best interest for you. Alan Williams, a millionaire. Much love.